The final vital sign of the economy is inflation. High levels of inflation or deflation can have negative impacts on the economy, mostly in the form of uncertainty. There are several ways to calculate inflation. In this section, we will focus on the Consumer Price Index. The Consumer Price Index, or CPI, is a measure of the price level based on the consumption patterns of a typical consumer. The index allows us to measure the cost of living, and therefore we can compare cost across geographies or time. There are other measures of price levels. We previously discussed the GDP deflator. The difference between the GDP deflator and the CPI is that the GDP deflator measures the prices of all goods in the economy, whereas the CPI focuses on the prices that the consumer purchases. Once we calculate the CPI, then we can easily measure inflation. Inflation is just the change in the price level from one year to the next. If the change in the price level is positive, then the economy is experiencing inflation. If, on the other hand, the price level decreases, then the economy has experienced deflation. Deflation also presents issues in the economy, and we will discuss those in this section. One thing that I'd like to note is don't get deflation mixed up with disinflation. It is a common mistake, happens all the time. Disinflation means that the economy experienced inflation, but the rate of inflation has decreased. So if inflation falls from 3% to 2%, then the economy experienced disinflation. Here is Consumer Price Index since 1980. We can see that the CPI is positively sloped, therefore we are experiencing inflation. But the growth rate is not consistent. Some years the slope is steeper and others it's flatter. Steeper slope years are associated with high levels of inflation. Flatter growth is associated with lower inflation. In some years we experience a decline in the CPI. Therefore, the economy has experienced deflation. We can see that the most recent deflation occurred between 2008 and 2009, when the CPI fell from 215 to 214. We can easily change this graph to represent inflation. Here, we are plotting the percentage change in the CPI between each year. The early 80s experienced high levels of inflation. The inflation rate in 1980 was 13.5%. We can also clearly see the deflation of 2009 in this graph. In 2019, the inflation rate was 1.8%. Volatility in the price level creates uncertainty in the economy and makes planning more difficult. In this series of videos, we will talk about how CPI is measured and the consequences of inflation and deflation on the economy. See you next class.